Welcome back, everyone, to probably the last part of Final Fantasy XIII. We fought our way through the battle-ravaged streets of Cocoon. We're going to go into Eden Hall to try and stop Orphan from being fucked up. And, yeah, we'll see how that goes.
Oh, yay, an elevator. Can I make a QR code real quick?
Yeah, Dragonscale's been kind of going overboard in the QR codes. I mean, we mentioned before she's done Vanille and Hope, but she just confirmed to me that she's now done Lightning and Snow. So we're slowly building up a good collection here, which I think is quite nice.
Plus my collection of Tales of series QR codes and Yu-Gi-Oh! And Chrono Crusade and pretty much anything else that I actually really like. God damn your skirt, Vanille. God damn it! Probably in your beads! We'll see him soon enough. I'm sorry, I'm not blaming Vanille. I'm not.
Well, now we know what happened to them.
Oh.
They all became...
Seath.
I'm trying to think of a funnier name than just saying what they were, but I can't think that fast right now.
They're all Seath. Sparkly? No, they became vampires.
Yeah, just vampires.
And they still look better than Edward freaking Cullen.
Oh no, what is happening? Oh.
Tinkerbell is here.
Well.
Jubileus, we pray!
Oh, if she shows up, we're fucked.
No, because then Bayonetta comes through the door. It's like, I think we made a wrong turn somewhere.
Oh well.
It's like, so, little ones, what's happening here? Oh.
We've kind of come here, this funky place.
We opened the mindfuck door.
Yeah. I'll explain this because the game doesn't really explain it that well. Because, here we are, Orphan's Cradle. Because Orphan is so important, they've basically hidden it in this giant thing. So we need to navigate our way through this mindfuck.
This is it. A lot of dreams died to get us here, and we can't let it be for nothing.
You and your funny belts.
It's not just our future we're fighting for.
We'll do it for everyone. Fal'Cy rule ends here.
Dysley, we're coming for you!
I feel like that should have had a whole lot better music. Like, it should have been, like, more pumped up.
I know, because we're not at just the end yet. So, yeah. Again, this is going to have some of the probably the most difficult fights in the game at some points. But luckily, because thanks to the power of cheats, we should be completely ready for this. So pay it no mind. And we're just going to carry on like nothing's wrong.
Hooray.
Yeah, I like this area. It's just, it's one of the more visually interesting things to see and explore through.
It just looks red. It kind of looks like we're wandering around Knuckles' intestine.
Ooh, hello.
Oh god, the angels are here! The angels are here! Or not.
Ooh.
Ah, that is the closest to Bayonetta we will get in this game. That right there.
That, yeah, close enough. The white one can be Jean.
And the gold one can be Balder.
Ah, oh, last chance to escape, I see.
You can either go and go forward and fulfill your destiny, or you can run away like little bitches. I'm actually just a shop.
What's going on?
That looks like a gate to Grand Pulse.
The last gift from our.
Yeah, this is basically saying, yeah, if you want to do any of the extra side stuff, turn back now.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
All your base, I belong to us. My dog.
Alright, so to explain, these floating things with the staffs are the Fal'Cy Eden. They're the thing that is it's basically Eden, or the things that Eden uses to communicate with people. It's the way that the government got their orders from stuff. And they're giving us a choice to leave, or to continue on to this next section, we have to basically follow after Eden to transport us to different places so we can eventually get to Orphan. Which, you know, is the standard fare of follow the pathways, try not to fight that much, and just keep going. And everything should be wonderful.
Yeah, in terms of RPG, I just love how these things are just kind of like dum 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 dum. Oh, hey, they went that way. Never mind.
Right, examine. I'm going to stare at you until you do what I want.
Where are your legs?
Ooh. Oh, it's Mass Effect platforms.
Oh, good.
It's like the ones in the collector ship.
Oh, God. I never actually got to the collector ship. I'm still working on it.
Oh, we'll get there eventually in our own playthrough.
Because I don't understand what's going on. Because Grudge actually showed me, or told me, I should say, that in order to get all, make sure everybody lives, that you have to go down and do Legion's thing before you do anything. And then Legion's thing wouldn't activate. I'm like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah, it's in the console version, it's a bit tricky. After the ship gets boarded, you can do Legion's mission to, like, without threatening killing the rest of the crew. And that's only in the console version. In the PC version that we're going to be using, because it is better, they've fixed that so you can end up doing the mission before the collectors board the ship, so there's no risk of killing anyone. They kind of did something wrong with the console version. So, I, like, you know, in a way it should work, but it kind of doesn't.
So I'm having to go through and fight all the husks again.
It's not too bad. Husks are piss easy.
If you shoot their legs out from under them, yeah, but if you go for the torso like I did before I even thought about, hey, let's find a weakness, it took forever.
Oh, well, you learn.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually.
For anybody who hears any crunching, I do apologize. I've not eaten since this morning, and at this time of the playthrough, it's like 8:40. So, yeah.
Yeah, 1:40 in the morning for me, because time difference is fun.
Yay!
Right, I'm gonna fix that so we go there. Okay. And onwards to fight more giant fish.
The giant fluffy fish.
I can't get past no, I've gone the wrong way. Whoops.
They have web feet.
Well, I deserve that.
So, are these essentially like beta ducks?
It's one way to describe them, I suppose.
Oh god, no, they're Dragonites. They're Dragonites, motherfucker.
I don't know, they're Dagonites. They're the bootleg version that you get off like street vendors in China.
Oh god.
Oh, you'll get Dagonite in this version.
Oh, I get Dragonite?
No, you'll get Dagonite. He better than Dragonite. He giant fish.
That sounds lame.
No, giant fish is best. Magikarp Kanto Gyarados is very good. Like, that's the example they used to say, this is why it's not shit, because another fish in the game turns into something cool.
Yeah, but you've gotta, like, but it seriously has no attacks unless you give it, like, some kind of, unless you give it, like, an HM or a TM, it has nothing, and so you have to keep switching it out, and you got your ass kicked there.
Yeah, so I did, but luckily we have healers, and Hope is actually useful at doing it now, so we're gonna be fine. Ow.
I'm so excited for Pokemon Go, I really am.
Is that the one where it's, like, augmented reality stuff where you have to scan the, like, real life and you go, oh, it's a Pokemon's.
Well, what it is, they will, like, release certain things. I'm not sure how the thing does it, if it's, like, some kind of, if it reads data from a different signal, or if you get close enough to a certain kind of Wi-Fi signal or something, if it does it, I don't know. But it's supposedly, Pokemon are all in different places. You get this little thing that says, hey, you're about this far from one, and you can capture them and do whatever. The dick move that they have done is that they make some Pokemon only available in certain areas. So unless you feel the need to travel everywhere over the course of your life to do this, you're only going to get a certain amount. Unless you, like, trade.
People hack it. It's fine. I give it a month before people crack it and get every single Pokemon ever.
Well, I don't know. It's on iOS and Android, so I don't know.
Yeah, but... Yeah, iOS and Android have already been jailbroken, though, so someone will find a way.
This is true.
Everyone finds a way to cheat. That's just the rule of games. Whoops.
In the words of Jeff Goldblum, life finds
cheat, cheaters, find,
a way.
Way.
So, see, so, and, life, it finds a way.
Okay.
Shit. I swear to God, that man can get so annoying because he does the same performance every time he's on screen.
He hasn't, like, been in anything for ages, though. Like, I haven't seen him in any modern kind of movies for the longest time.
He's been in, shit, I think he was in one of the new Law and Orders, actually.
Wow, he's gone from, like, AAA movies to, I appear in a,
crime drama.
A crime drama for, one, episode.
Actually, he's a main character, so he's in there a lot.
Oh, that's curious.
Mm-hmm. I'd have to look that up, but I'm almost positive it's one of the, damn it, I started doing that, now I can't stop. one of the Law and Orders, so I'm gonna have to look that up, though. Hold on.
I'm gonna probably get transported to a boss fight, or... Oh no, I'm just gonna rearrange everything, that's fine. Take me to new interesting places, please.
Okay, so he's in Criminal Intent. Let's see.
Oh, now I have to get all the way down there? Come on, man! Come on, man, you're busting my balls here!
You're busting my balls!
Yeah,
I
don't get it either, Fang. I don't get it either.
Okay, so he joined the cast as Detective Zach Nichols in season 8.
My name is, Zach, Nichols,
I am, a detective.
I swear, I am,
Gary, shoot him, please! For the love of God. I don't know why I went Mass Effect there. It just kind of felt right.
I was what was on the previous mind conversation, I guess. I need to heal Fang before she gets fucked.
Yeah.
Fang, stop having all these hit status things put on you. Right, okay. Right, you stay guarding. I'm going to heal up a little bit, and then we're going to destroy everything, and it's going to be beautiful.
No, Chiefer, you can't have my pizza.
Oh, dogs. There are some dogs that just have mastered the art of begging for food, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Like, he's giving me toothless eyes and kind of licking his nose.
Please, I want the pizza.
Please, Mommy. Look at my half-fed ears.
Yeah, I imagine that if Toothless was living in the modern day, he would, like, fucking go crazy for pizza. Especially
if they had anchovies on it.
Yeah, especially anchovies, I was just about to say that. Yeah, still on the How to Train Your Dragon kit, guys, just as a warning, still going.
Oh yeah.
It's not going to stop, considering that as we're recording this, the next batch of episodes for Race to the Edge came out, and I binge-watched all of them. life is good. For now. Right, Fang.
Whereas I'm still stuck in the tales of crap fest, but yeah. More importantly, I've gotten to a Fallout actually now. I take that back.
Yeah, that's true. And speaking of tales, I have purchased Tales of Zestiria to see what all the fuss is about. It ain't bad so far. I need to play more of it to have a full opinion, but it ain't bad.
Yeah, it's alright.
Yeah, I think that what Drenska will really be concerned about is when they make Symphonia for the PC, which should be coming out this year.
Yes.
Then she'll be wanting to see what my reaction to that is more than anything else.
Oh yeah, because like I said, Tales of Symphonia was what got me into the Tales series. That game, man, that game.
All the thunders for everything. You know what, I'm gonna do this.
I swear to God, if they make plushies of this Hysteria cast, I'm getting everybody, but I'm getting Saraya and McLeo first.
Woo! I destroyed you with Lightning's Awesome Attack. Nice.
Huzzah.
All right, well, that was fun, but we're gonna carry on like that didn't happen.
Whee!
All right, now take me to the next part of the collector. Cradle.
Take me to the next area of the land of Canaan. Yeah. You won't know what that is yet. You will see that later.
Yeah, I'll get there eventually. I'm very slow to play it because I'm so busy during the week most of the day.
Well, actually, that's not Zestiria. I'm referring to Zillia 2 when I finally get my Roxio and we do that.
Oh, yeah. We'll get there eventually. As well as that. Not just Zestiria. I mean, I'm hoping you're going to do all the Jack games. All right.
Well, I don't know. I mean, do we want to do 2?
Yeah, if it's possible.
I'll try my best, but we might be editing a lot of deaths out.
Ah, it's fine. It's fine. We know the game's bullshit. We've discussed this before about how the game is bullshit, so if there are any stupid bits, we will cut them out.
Mm-hmm.
Besides, I want to see how good Dragon Scale is at game, because I've never seen it in person yet.
I suck!
Ah, you can't suck. You've obviously beaten some, which is more than people who are really bad can say.
I knew how to play Sly, which was better than what we saw the preview guy doing.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
We were both yelling at the demo screen. It's like, press the circle button, goddammit!
What is wrong with you?
It says on the screen, press the button!
It's like Bentley's favorite phrase. Just fucking do it.
Jump and press the circle button, Sly!
What do I do? The game's not telling me what to do.
Jump and press the circle button, you fucking raccoon!
Like, Bentley, I don't know what that means, and apparently they don't either.
Oh, dear. Sly. Yeah, we'll do all of those, except one, because one is bad. Well, it's not bad, but it has problems.
Has about the similar problem as Jack 2 does. The checkpoint system are bullshit, and the health system is absolutely stupid.
Yeah. Plus, you don't really need to play it to enjoy the other games.
Yeah.
Because every single game, they always introduce the backstory to everyone anyway, so... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they really had to condense it in the third game.
Yeah, but they still did it. Like, yeah. It's one of those series that's lucky enough that you don't need to play previous ones to enjoy it.
Yeah.
A bit like Final Fantasy! So, yeah, we've gone full circle.
Absolutely. The Tales of games are actually the same way.
Yep. Different universes, different everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Grudge was actually telling me he did see a bit of a Final Fantasy flavor in what he's actually played of Zestiria.
Yeah, like, I can see parts of it that are very Final Fantasy-ish, especially in, like, some of the design choices and some of the battle system things. Like, it reminds me a lot of the System of 12, where you kind of basically set up what your characters are going to do beforehand. It was a system I couldn't get used to in 12, but it's a lot easier in Zestiria.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty good.
Yeah, the thing I didn't like about it is they changed it, because, are you still running off the default controls?
Yeah, I haven't changed anything, I'm just running what it tells me to.
Okay, are you using the keyboard or a controller?
Oh, actual controller. Also, okay. I kind of hacked to get loads of these things, so I'm going to wear one of these so no enemies notice me, because I do not want to fight anyone. Bye!
Woohoo! But the way it works in old Tales games is the X button is actually the button that does your basic melee attacks, you know, slashy, slashy, slashy. And the circle button was what you utilize in conjunction with the directional stick to get the special moves. In Zestiria, it's flip-flopped.
Yeah, I mean, again, I haven't got a basis for comparison to see how it's changed. I just know that it has, according to what Dragon Scales told me, so I will take everyone's word for it.
Well, it's interesting. It's just they took out the directional stick to utilize to get the certain moves you want. Now it's just a matter of what combination you put with your. Well, no, I take that back. They do have the directional stick, but it's not as widespread as in Zestiria 2, is what I'll say.
Yeah, I think my biggest problem with Zestiria so far is that it seems like all of my actions have, like, a very unnecessary, like, start-up, except for melee attacks. Like, whenever I do amortization, it's like, to do anything, I have to wait a second to actually do the ability, and then when I'm in the middle of doing just the beginning animation, I get hit and it gets interrupted. Which you think, for an action RPG, shouldn't be allowed to do that.
Yeah, and I was telling him about this earlier, is that that's his Seraphic Arts. It kind of sucks, especially when you're fighting when you're not armatized, because some of your seraphs are sitting there, like, charging these really powerful moves, and you gotta sit there and protect them so they're not gonna get smacked. Oh, man. I seriously had to guard Mikleo a lot during the early parts of the game. I'm like, fucking hell!
Like, come on, man, just...
Like, Mikleo cast it already! God damn it! God, you're lucky you're cute.
The saving grace of all useless anime characters.
He's adorable, I can't help it.
Yeah, I need to see more of the relationship between these two, because Dragon Scale keeps swearing to God that these two are amazing together, and I'm just like, I haven't seen enough yet. I'll say I don't see it yet. Or maybe I'm just stupid.
I don't know. I saw it really early on, just because I liked that the idea. I don't know. It may just be an implied thing between people who really want to see it, but I don't know.
I mean, obviously, I thought the implication of them having some sort of thing is there. I just haven't seen enough of the game to warrant that yet. I mean, the only thing I've seen of note between them is when they had this really awkward kind of forced bust up that made no sense near the beginning. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm angry! And it's like, no, don't be angry. Okay, I won't be angry. Here, let's beat stuff. And then they beat stuff. And it's like, you know, you could have kind of skipped over that, guys.
Yeah, the whole fight between them was a little weird. Because right. I'm sitting here like, no, don't go away! Sarai, talk to him! You guys are best friends! Okay, you're not gonna do it. Okay.
Oh, fuck. I remember the trouble you guys caused Saz and Vanille. This is gonna be revenge. You're not gonna kill me first time this time. Because fuck you, all of you.
Oh god, I thought I'd seen those things before.
Yeah. Did you use an ability called Mucosphere? Did you just gob at me? dude, that is gross and... Oh my god, hope.
Dude, you just hawked a loogie at my face.
Dude, that's not cool. That is some serious fucked up shit right there. Alright, I've got Imperil on anything, so any element is good. I have deep.
And the Mome Rats outgrade.
Are you Nature's Blessing? Nature's Blessing just sounds like some kind of bullshit line that you would get from people who think that superfoods are a thing.
this thing has like 2,000,000% of your recommended allowance of vitamin B9.
No. You do not understand how nutrition works. Sorry.
There's only so much the body can absorb. After that, you're just gonna piss it out.
Like, quite literally as well. So, mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's why I love, when I worked at Walmart, I saw all these people buying all these different multivitamins. And I'm like, is this for your kids? Like, no, I take them all.
You silly, silly, silly person. These do no good for you.
It's like, this, you're essentially just buying the ingredients to very expensive urine.
Yeah, you're gonna get some fancy and funky smelling stuff.
And that is not mine, that is Big Bang Theory.
Oh, Big Bang Theory. If there's one thing we've ever disagreed on, it will always be that. Forever.
It's still so fun, though.
No, it's not. It is the worst thing ever, and you should be ashamed for saying you like it, in any capacity.
I meant your reaction to me saying I like it. This is hilarious.
That's because I'm right. You're bad for liking it. And I don't usually call you bad in anything, but you just are.
Well, you are, well, right very loosely. The loosest definition of right is in your
No,
hate.
I am completely 100% correct in the notion that anyone who likes that show is a bad person, kind of.
Your opinion?
No, it's complete fact, and you can't say otherwise.
That's why it has, like, what, 8 seasons now?
Yeah, just because something's popular doesn't mean it's good. Look at Avatar, look at Transformers, movies,
things
that made millions of dollars, and they're still shit. So, popular never means good, okay?
Do not lump Big Bang Theory in with Blue Smurf Cats.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll lump it in with shows that have stupid catchphrases and basically makes, hey, geek culture, isn't it funny that they enjoy things? Let's laugh at their misfortune. Ha ha.
And I'm gonna insist upon where I told you that it's not laughing at them for liking their stuff. It's laughing because they're quirky and they're funny and we love them.
No, it's laughing at them for their habits and the things they like. It's like, look at this guy spouting off things about physics. Isn't that geeky and weird? Ha ha! No!
He's more laughing. We have no idea what they're saying.
No! This show is an abomination. No one should like it. Anyone who does like it needs to feel guilty.
I think we have found Grudge's button.
I'm sorry, guys. I know I'm interrupting your moments of going towards the end of your epic journey, but fuck me, Big Bang Theory is the worst.
I can't
I think we should go back to the game. This is much better conversation.
Ouch! Ow! Ow! It hurts!
Does it hurt? Good, because it should.
Okay, what the fuck's happening? I think I missed something.
You see, that's the great thing. See, I've just proven that I can be fucking funnier than the Big Bang Theory! You know, I didn't need a laugh track to do any of this shit. This was all live. Legit reactions.
Ow!
Oh god, what's happening? Okay.
I'm gonna say something and stop laughing, I hope. the candy cane rings. Woohoo!
At least he changed the environment to actually get us anywhere. I mean, we haven't missed much so far. It's basically just navigating this mess until we get anywhere.
Yay, we're running around through the crystal. Actually, you know what these things remind me of? I don't know if they ever had these candies in Europe, but they were like little creams where, they're hard candies that were like strawberry and cream. They're like just hard little candies. I don't know what they were called.
Were they like the ones that had like a swirl pattern on them or something?
Yes, yes.
Yes, we have those.
Okay.
I don't know what their name is, I just know they exist.
I say, the strawberry ones were freaking... Oh my god, I love them.
I can't get past this guy, can I? Fine, okay, I guess you're gonna die. Fuck you.
This'll be quick. We hope.
Ow.
Oh no! Not a great start, guys.
Alright, well let's get rid of Big Machine Guy first, because he's gonna be the biggest problem.
Aw, so we're not gonna get rid of the Templar first?
Nah,
what a shame we are to our assassin roots. Damn it.
We'll get to that eventually. Because, yeah, I got Assassin's Creed Brotherhood to work. So I can actually, I can film it and everything's beautiful now. So,
is Brotherhood's before the Age of Suck, right?
Yeah, the Age of Amazing is 2, Brotherhood, Revelations, and 3. Everything after that is the Age of Suck. Then
okay.
Cash Cow.
Yeah, because they came out with a new one, didn't they, with the twins?
Yeah, Syndicate.
Oh, God.
I mean, apparently it wasn't as buggy as Unity was. Like, it actually functioned as a game, but it was just kind of bland.
Yeah, I saw Vegeta play a little bit on TFS Renegade for Life, and I'm sitting here like, I'm bored.
Yeah, I think it's just because that after you play a few Assassin's Creed games, you kind of know the formula of how it's going to pan out, so it does get a bit stale after a while, which is why whenever I play them, I take big breaks in between doing one game and another. Because if you do play them all back-to-back, you'll see... It's a bit like if you go to a concert of someone you've only heard, like, a few songs by, and you kind of like them, but you're not sure. And then if you hear all their songs back-to-back, you're like, this is the same song over and over. And I should know this because I've been subjected to this. Where I went to a concert with my cousin for a band, for a guy that I was like, oh, he makes okay individual songs, he's had a few hits. And I went to go see him, it was like, and then you hear all of it back to back, and it's just, wow.
Like, this is the same fucking shit.
Yeah, it's the same thing with Assassin's Creed. If you play them all back to back or in a very short time span, or see them all back to back, it gets stale very quickly.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think the same could be said for a lot of game series. Like, if you honestly look at Jack and Dexter and, like, Ratchet and Clank, the early games for Ratchet and Clank, when you play through them, it's just, you know, it's the same thing. Go to a planet, kill these guys with funny weapons, go to this planet, kill these guys, funny weapons, you know.
Well, I think the thing that they did with Ratchet and Clank is that they added more variation of everything in every sequel, so when you have, in Ratchet and Clank, although they were all being made on the same engine, so they were relatively easy to make, you're introducing new different weapon mechanics, you're introducing new ways of, oh shit, I died. I'm sorry, guys. I was paying too much attention to ranting about games than you. I'm sorry.
We fail at life. We're sorry.
We'll be back. Okay, we did it. I'm gonna go somewhere else. I've passed by all that bullshit. I'm not doing any more of this. Fuck you. Fuck everything.
Man, I want some of those strawberry creams now. Damn it.
Now I want them, and I don't even know where you can get them from anymore.
I swear they're sold at... I don't even know. I've not seen them in a while, but I could have sworn they were sold at, like, regular candy shops.
Oh, dear. Alright, so now we have that machine and two Seath. Yeah, this is going to go just as well as the other one. Fun!
Oh, great.
Anyway, as I was saying in the previous conversation before I messed up... yeah, even though Ratchet and Clank, I was like on the same engine and they added in a bunch of new stuff. Or like the same kind of things and it was relatively easy to make. I'm actually just going to quit this and try and get around them. They added in enough to make it different. Like, they added in new mechanics for some of the gadgets. They added in mechanics for a bunch of other things. And it made it fun to play. And the early Assassin's Creed did the same thing. Like, they added in new mechanics of moving around. They added in the execution kills. They added in a bunch of stuff that made them much better to play than afterwards. But then you look at, like, all the new games, and it's like, they haven't really changed that much. They're just kind of following a formula of, oh, you can do this, and, oh, we've made the animations look better, but we haven't introduced any real new gameplay elements. So, I don't know. And with the Jack games, they changed a lot between other games. Like, you had a massive tonal shift between 1 and 2, and then with 3, you had, like, decent vehicle exploration and everything.
Well, what I was referring to is after the first game. So you had 2, 3, then they changed everything. So, it really only spanned a very short time, but Jack 2 and Jack 3 had a very similar feel to them. If not different story, but a very similar way of playing.
Yeah, well, different feels are fine. It's when game developers just literally make the same game every year that's becoming a problem. Like, Call of Duty, you know?
Oh, wait, are you serious? The new Assassin's Creed play almost exactly the same every new game?
Well, from what I've observed of them, it's literally like they're using a similar kind of engine style. Like, Assassin's Creed 4 used a similar engine to 3, and they didn't really add much because all the naval combat was borrowed from Assassin's Creed 3. A lot of the other systems were like some minor sandbox stuff, but the game played exactly the same. Assassin's Creed Rogue, which was kind of like the last one to be released on like PS3 and everything, that exclusively was just a reskin of Assassin's Creed 4. You had the same animation, same everything, and they released that as something brand new. Unity, wow. They had like a new engine to make it look nicer and it and you know, had the animations nicer and like a bunch of different crowds and stuff. And when it worked, it was nice to look at, but then what you were left with was a broken game that just felt like a really lazy kind of rehash of stuff. And from what I've seen of Syndicate, they're doing the same thing again. They basically said, alright, we've made it function, but it's the same old, same old. Like, whenever they show off, like, oh, now you can do this, and now you can do this, it's not really a case of now we're doing something new. It's like, oh yeah, you remember when you could recruit people for the Brotherhood? Well, you can do that in this game as well. We're carrying that on. Oh, you remember when you could hijack vehicles? Yeah, we're carrying that on too. You remember when you could upgrade your weapons? Yeah, we're carrying that on too. So, I think it's just a matter of points where game companies get really complacent and they don't really want to do that much different. I mean, if you're doing it for like one sequel, a la Bayonetta, then, you know, fine. Don't change what isn't broken. But if you're going to carry it on well beyond that, you need to be doing different stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same, it's like with Final Fantasy, to use reference to doing here. Like, this game plays and looks and feels completely different to Final Fantasy XII, for example. Mm-hmm. And there was a big gap between all the games, so the difference in the style and how the story's told and how it plays is noticeable, and that's a good thing. If every single Final Fantasy game played exactly the same way as the old ones, like a lot of people want them to for some reason, then, you know, it just becomes boring. And there's too many games nowadays that are kind of doing that, so I'm always on the lookout for things. Oh, maybe they're doing this different from other things. Or it takes, like, a lot more to gather my interest now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tails actually does that as well. With all the games that have been released, I haven't played any of the ones that came before Symphonia, but from the ones I have played, you know, Symphonia, Abyss, Graces, Zillia, Zestiria, you know, all of that, that they're all different. They all have different things that make them unique. You know, for Zillia, it was partners. It was, you know, the link ups where you could do different link attacks with your partner. With Abyss, I think it was the phonons, which I still for some reason cannot do, even though it gives me the stupid tutorial. It's broken. But then again, I'm playing it on 3DS, so maybe that has something to do with it.
Yay!
but you know, and then Symphonia is your basic RPG. You know, hey, I've got these guys. I've got these different moves. I've got healers, clear. You know, I got tanks. You know, rogues, ranged. I shouldn't say rogue, but ranged fighters, things of that nature. And then you've got Lloyd, which has two swords, and you just go in and fuck their face up with a blade. Boom!
There's a lot of things that I think if it's a long-running series, you need to do more than just release a new game. You need to add stuff that makes it feel different to the one before it, but still carrying on the same themes and such that make it that make people like your game in the first place. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens at E3 and see if anything new comes around, but it seems like a lot of what's come out is either remakes of old stuff, or it's just the same series we've come to expect. So I assume Ubisoft will launch another Assassin's Creed, there'll be another Call of Duty, there'll be another kind of generic
How do you make another thing. Call of Duty? It's just basically you're going around killing each other.
I don't understand. How do you make it different? They add new maps, and that's it. Yeah, it's not that great.
Well, then again, I've heard, my boyfriend told me about this when he bought, I think it was it Advanced Warfare?
It was Black Ops 3.
Black Ops 3,
Yeah, also a little cameo appearance by him in the background
Just to... Yeah, so, yeah, this is Dragon Scale's boyfriend, Whiny Chimera? Is that what your username is, baby?
Yeah.
The Whiny Chimera.
Yeah. yeah, he doesn't whine so much, but, you know.
Nah, he's not whiny at all, but, So he was telling me that Black Ops 3, you actually have to buy the season pass and the game to play it. So you have to pay $60 for the game itself, and then like another $60 or something to play the game for a year. And you have to do that every time you want to, like anytime that goes out. So it's essentially you have to pay $60 a year to play this fucking game.
Yeah, that's kind of like the norm for most multiplayer shooting games now. It's just literally the case of, oh, you want to play the game? Well, you need online capability, you need to buy all the DLC, you need to buy a bunch of other shit, and...
Baby, go away.
You know, it's baby, silly. And the problem is that as much of a bad system as that is, like, they'll keep doing it because people are willing to pay for it, so... Mm-hmm.
Which I don't understand.
Yeah, like, I see people, like, rage about DLC practices all the time, and then it's like, well, if you don't want them to do it, don't buy anything, and then they just do it anyway. Or you say, oh, you know, you shouldn't pre-order games because of reasons. I'm like, well, if you don't want to, if you think that's a bad thing, don't pre-order games, and net they'll pre-order games. It's, be consistent with your activism, guys.
Speaking of which, I think I need to go ahead and pre-order the Ratchet & Clank game, because according to what I've read, you get, like, a little model of one of the weapons, plus then I can get it, so, yeah.
So, proving my point. yeah,
well, hey, I like that. I was going to get the game anyway, why may as well get the little freebie thing.
Yeah, I've lost my faith in pre-ordering. The only thing I've ever pre-ordered in my life was Bayonetta 2, and that was for the Ultimate Edition that came with a bunch of stuff and was limited in number. But a lot of other pre-orders nowadays, there's people who are, you know, they're kind of abusing the whole concept of pre-order for other stuff, so I've lost faith in it. I don't pre-order stuff anymore, I just buy it when I can. The only things that would come close to that would be like, oh, if you buy the game now on Steam just after it's been released, you get a special discount price. But, you know, I don't buy it before release, I don't do anything like that, so... Who knows?
Yeah, I think they did. I thought they did something similar with the Zestiria, where they got the Alicia DLC for her special chapter thing.
Alicia.
Sure. Yeah. I don't mind Alicia in Tales of Zestiria. She seems very bland in some regards, where it's just, you know, your typical anime, you know, very quiet, very innocent naivete thing, where it's like,
I am of royal blood, but by the end of this game I will want you to ravage me. It's that obvious kind of trope where it's like, oh no, I'm very duty bound, and by the end I can tell, yeah, you're gonna be a thing, aren't you?
Well, it's actually very interesting what happens with Alicia. I'm gonna go ahead and say this, because you're gonna find it out anyway. She's actually not with you for the majority of the game once you get to a certain point.
Seems very odd. Like,
yeah.
if she's been introduced and treated at this point as a main character, and it's like, oh, by the way, she's not here.
Yeah, after a certain point in the game, she'll leave, and you won't get her back until probably close to the end of the game.
Well, I hope she levels up in all the time that she's away, otherwise we're doomed.
Yeah, which is really funny, because the game lets you find weapons for her in the treasure chest, even though it gets to a point where she's clearly not with you. And I'm like, I got one of her weapons one time. I'm like, oh, cool. And I missed the fact that it said spear and it didn't say staff. Because I thought it said staff, but it said spear. I don't know where I saw staff, whatever. So I'm like, oh, cool. That sounds badass. I'm going to give that to Miklio. And he's like, where the fuck is it? It's like, oh, God, it said spear. God damn it.
You can't. Mm. Like, and you just look at the weapon and go, you have no power here.
Fuck no. Mickey can't get a break.
If you stop binging saying, I want to save the world too, then maybe you wouldn't get shit on so much. Why won't you let me save the world, Saray? And it's like, I will! Stop being a bitch about it!
Saray had no intention of letting Miklio come along until Lila basically said, you're a fucking moron! There is nothing that would have changed that.
Saray, I want to save the world too.
Hey, now back off now.
Saray,
I like Miklio.
I
want to. Leave Mickey alone now. You're traipsing into very dangerous.
Let me come along with you. I want to save the world too, you dumb.
Now, I got really mad at Saray when he was like, yeah, you can't come. It's not your dream. It's like, Alicia wants to come. Oh, okay. You stupid. What? What's the problem with Miklio coming? He's stronger than Alicia, for God's sake! Whatever.
Yeah, all I'm saying is that it didn't help that he whinged about it as well.
Yeah, it really didn't.
He could have been the better person and said, you know, I'll prove that I'm better than this. Oh, we've actually finally done this nightmare.
Final fucking league.
Yeah, all that. So you know, 40 minutes of just fighting getting this. Don't worry, Fang, we'll be okay. This is it. Let's go! Oh. Oh, it's... Oh. Whoa, spinny! Okay.
Oh. I don't like that.
Whoa! It's the Stargate! Off-wall activation.
It's like they just come out of the Stargate and they're like, what the hell? I really think we made it wrong.
Welcome to Earth, SG-13.
SG-13. What?
Right, can I do anything? No, these weapons are shit. Never mind. Is there anything else? I'm just double-checking because we do have the final few fights coming up, so I want to make sure. I will need these, so I bought loads. So yeah. First thing I want to do is that I need to make sure that Lightning has basically as many of these equipped as possible, these Cherub's Crowns. You'll notice how it says it increases death resistance.
What the fuck?
Which is basically, you know, it means that the enemy can't instantly kill you, which will be nice. I bought way too many of these. Yeah, Sorcerer's Mine.
Why are you fighting a sentry bot?
Yeah, so we're going to have a boss fight that can basically kill me in one hit if I'm not careful. So I need to have as many of those equipped so that I have a 90% resistance to being killed by it. And everything will be glorious.
Where's it going?
To kill. Oh, and treasure chest, obviously, just to get going. With something that Ethersol, I can't use.
Is that booze?
Ethersol sounds like booze.
But it really does.
But it ain't booze, it just sounds like it.
I don't always act like a jackass, right. But when I do, Ethereal.
Hey, look at the planet down there. Ain't it pretty?
It just basically looks like a stormy sky.
Alright, well, this is it. This is what we're gonna do. Are we ready, guys? Are you ready for the ending? Are you ready for the thing that's gonna end all this to the end of everything?
Whoever designed these trials sure liked the idea of people walking into bright lights.
Well, yeah, a lot of Japanese games do have noise. It's like you go into a bright light and it's like, transition. Yeah. Alright, so I'm going to go in with that. I'm also going to go in with that.
What?
So, yeah, here we go.
That was also a Yu-Gi-Oh! Capsule Monsters joke, by the way.
Oh, look, it's the doll thing again.
Oh my god, we're entering Zexal territory now, shit.
Let's do this. Go on, Lightning.
Show your badass bamfness.
Right,
and yes, I realize I just said badass, badass mofo.
Badassness, badass mofo. Well, here we are. Orphan's down there somewhere. So let's hope that no one's going to be there to stop us, because that would be really bad.
It kind of looked like Hope was rolling his eyes there. It's like, I have to do this, okay, fine, whatever.
Well, let's do this.
For some reason, I feel the urge to say, if we live through this, I'm buying the first round and a second.
I wonder why you think that, Saz. I don't know, it's like... There's a presence here, like a wheel or something.
A wheel or something, and a bald guy.
And he had a shotgun and...
Moment of truth, hero.
Break our legs. No?
Nope.
We're too good for
I would just loved if Vanilla like just fell on her ass. It'd been funny.
Well, she did that before.
Yeah. I'm still surprised her spine didn't come out of her head. Bleh. Just like in Erba.
I live in the town of Erba.
Erba. It's a beautiful instrument.
Oh god, not you.
Oh fucking hell, why? Go!
Hey!
Oh my god!
Sarar and Douge, no!
Surrounding. Hey, it's Eagle Bitch!
Ooh. Hello, you.
I'm going to sit on my throne like a pimp.
No, don't do it.
Oh, no! You didn't know it just...
What a dick.
Oh, you dead! You dead!
No, this is the third time you've done that, okay?
Okay, wait, what?
It's an illusion, that's fine.
Wait, what? Wait, what?
No, it's all fake. It isn't real.
It's just Fauci's smoke.
Look,
good.
I killed them. No, you didn't.
Yeah. Oh, good. Whew. Oh, boy. Okay, I'm about to say, he's like, oh, that is a dick.
Well, he's a dick for implying it anyway.
This is very true. He's like, oh, we are going to enjoy killing you.
Come on.
I love how all of them are like lined up to take him on all at once, and then the game just shows, because you only have three people in your party, and then, so it's like, what are the other three doing? Just sitting there watching?
Like, yeah, you can do it, Latin.
I think we may have covered this topic before, actually. But it's still fun. It's like we're all lined up, like hell yeah, and then oh okay, you guys are up first. All right, we're gonna go sit over here.
Oh come on, we're not doing this. We've been over this. We're not.
Mercy? You mean murder? And cocoon. Show the children first, and then the lady, then the guy, then the incompetent bitch, and now the hero. Hello.
Yeah.
Kick his ass, Claire.
Oh, shut up. We've killed you twice. We'll do it a third time if it's gonna help.
Third time's the charm. You and your pointy purple pimp hat. Orestes, fly, my pet.
Oh, here we go again.
Just when you thought he couldn't get any uglier.
Kick his face! Kick his face! Luckily, this fight against Barthandalus is actually one of the easier ones. I mean, the second one that I thought I wasn't going to win, I always die on that. This one I can usually get away with because he's not that difficult.
Which doesn't make much sense, honestly.
Yeah, but he isn't the final boss, I should point out. This isn't it. So, he's kind of like a tester saying, like, oh, can you beat me now? And I'm like, yeah, I guess.
Like, go fuck yourself, dude. I don't know why, but uh-oh. I always think that the head's on his... Oh, fuck.
Not Ultima, this is bad. Ow. Oh, actually, that was kind of good because I'm buffed up, so fuck you.
But no, it's weird. I always think those faces on, like, the size of... I'm the only other thing I can think of to describe it are his ears. It sounds like they're singing the vocal parts of this music.
Yeah.
It's like you're smacking us in the face and we still sing. That's dedication.
Yeah, as I said, best one of the best things about this game is the music. It's so good.
Oh, kick-ass backflip.
Whoa! Okay. That was a good idea. I'm glad we did that. Actually, no, you can't hurt me. I'm not bothered. Fuck you. This spell does nothing. Look, that was pathetic. Screw you, Bothandalus. You're not going to win. I'm just going to throw that out there. You are done. That's it.
Fuck you and all your shit.
Yeah, this is revenge for the other two times you've killed me. Actually, I know he killed me in the first time I fought him. Did I do the second one first time?
I think you did, actually, because I think I remember you going crazy about it.
Yeah, I was like, oh my god, I did it!
Like, holy shit! Like, congratulations, I have no idea what the difference is.
Yeah, it's, that fight I just always die on, and then for some reason... Oh, I remember you doing this one before. Come on. Hit me!
Blow the load!
Oh shit, that did way more than I wanted it to. Okay.
Oh shit.
Okay, so...
Blow all the missiles, man.
But still, if that's like your only decent attack, you're not doing a great job, I'm gonna say. Like... Yeah, Ultima can't hurt me. We've done this. See? That was rubbish. You're gonna die now.
I can go for some Smirnoff right now.
Did you say Smirnoff?
Smirnoff. How do you say it? Smirnoff?
Smirnoff.
I don't fucking...
I was like, you're not a drinker? Why do you want Smirnoff?
Well, my brother got me onto the really the light ones, the ice with the flavoring in them that's like 4.5 alcohol. They're so good.
Wow, we got... I would never thought I'd see the day when Dragonskin would admit that she likes an alcoholic drink, ever.
This thing does not taste like alcohol, it tastes like soda! I'm not even shitting you, Mike's tastes like it has more alcohol than a Smirnoff. It's so weird!
Yeah, because you can get Smirnoff in different concentrations, so I was thinking...
No, not the vodka, no!
Yeah, I was gonna say, you're not a vodka drinker, no.
No, not, oh god, no. I took one sip of vodka and almost spit it out, god. Ugh.
Which is interesting, because you can't really taste anything in vodka.
Well, my dad made kamikazes for my brother's 21st, and, it was kamikaze, I think it was kamikaze. Yeah, it was kamikaze. And I took one sip of it. I'm just like, this is furniture polish. Get this out of my mouth.
No, Bothandalus, don't take it. No.
No. Now these are really good. They just taste like a fruity kind of soda. It's really nice.
Huh, not bad. I think you'd like cider if you gave it a try. Because you can get some like really weak concentrations of it that just literally taste like fizzy apple juice.
Well, yeah, they have something like that. It's called a Red's Apple Ale over here. I tried some of that. It kind of does taste like apple juice, a little bit fermented, though.
Well, that is kind of the point of cider. Yeah,
that is the point. I'm painfully aware, and it really does. And that was the first thing I dad's now. It tastes like rotten apples. I'm like, Dad, that's the place. It's alcohol. They're fermented.
Yeah, I've made homemade cider with my dad before, and it actually came out amazingly.
Is there a drinking age in England? I can't remember.
It is, it's 18.
Okay.
Yeah, which is weird. Our age of consent is 16, age of drinking is 18. So obviously we're just more trustworthy than American youth, you know?
Our age of consent is 16, and our drinking age is 21.
That's so backwards to me.
I know, it's like, okay, so you can determine who it's okay for you to sleep with somebody, but you can't be trusted with alcohol until you're 20.
Yeah.
What?
I just love the fuckers like, oh yeah, you might be ready, you're ready to be parents in your late teens, but don't you dare think about touching the booze. It's like,
I know, right? Or the cigarettes, because it's, yeah, I mean, 18 to smoke.
Yeah, they're the real danger, obviously.
My god. It's like, I have to be 18 to suck on cancer sticks.
You want any more?
Yeah, I was thinking about getting some at some point.
You might,
yeah. Yeah, I'm painfully aware. I was wanting to go to Walmart before you decided to take my car for 7 hours.
Domestic disputes, guys, right on our show. You can find it all here.
Obviously, because you 2 hours, my ass.
I wonder if I'll actually cut this out or I'll actually leave it in. Because on all the previous videos, you might have noticed I've left them in because I can't be bothered. Yeah, I'm cutting this out. There's no way you're going to want to hear this. So I'm just going to be sniggering and you'll be left oblivious, audience.
Yeah, you say that and then you'll forget.
No, for this, the previous ones were fine, but this one is like, this is involving like domestic arguments, so I'm not having that.
We're not really arguing, I'm just giving him a ration of shit. Because here's what happened. This afternoon, he had to go to an aerosol meeting, and he said he'd only be there 2 hours. 7 hours later, he's just now coming home. Like, what do you could possibly talk about airsoft for 7 hours? You load the gun, you shoot it at stuff.
I don't know, for the same reason we can talk about video game entertainment for like an hour and 40 minutes at once.
But there's like video game shit. Coca-Cola light? It's a green Coca-Cola. Why do you keep busting in my room?
Yeah, you're not going to be able to hear this either, guys. Now we're having home invasions. Oh, it's all going. It's becoming a mess. This is not good.
He thinks just because he lives here, he can come busting into my room.
Asshole on no boundaries. Alright, let's just kill this guy and get on with it, because.
Is he not dead yet? Shit.
He's just about gone. I think one more round of lightning's best attack will do it. There we go. Go peacefully to your rest. And you
what
die.
What is been laid to rest?
We win! Die. Finally!
Two stars! What the fuck?
Oh, who cares? I don't care about star rating. All I know is that I finally beat you! You're not an illusion.
Are
you're
dead
actually
now?
Dead. Yeah, you're not an illusion. You're actually dead.
I love how Vanille, Snow, and Saz all have their game face on. I'm like, you guys did nothing!
Whoa.
Wow,
he really enjoyed being killed.
I'm not touching that with a 10-foot pole.
Oh, I'm glad you said pole that time. You didn't say spoon, which is
pole,
the
pole, spoon, whatever.
Well, pole's correct. Guys, Lightning's not convinced.
I'm scared here. There's a backdrop. Oh shit! The bird.
We forgot the bird.
God dang it. Ow, Snow, you did nothing. You don't deserve to be able to do a fist thrust. You don't get to do that. You did nothing. Oh, fucking hell, what is that? Arthendalus, Digivolve 2! Whatever the fuck this is! Being Mon, I guess. A mixture of Megatron and one of the stronger angels from Bayonetta. And a very creepy thing in the middle.
Tisley. Nope. No. Not anymore.
We are the abandoned one, born but now to die. What the hell?
Hello.
Oh, you must be fucking kidding me. You must be joking. Why is it stroking that strange thing in the middle?
Yeah, this is Orphan, guys.
I'm confused and horrified at the same time.
Basically, what happened is that Orphan, because it's kind of difficult to explain this, I'm just going to do a little bit of setup here. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to do this properly. Basically, what happened, Bathandalus died. Orphan, even though it is the power source to Eden North Cocoon, it was kind of sleeping. Like, it wasn't really, like, conscious or alive or anything, hence why it says, oh, we're now alive. But unfortunately, it also shares the same ideology as the rest of the Falsi, in that it knows that it needs to die in order to bring back the Maker. So it's now gonna purposely fight us to try and make us kill it. And that's gonna suck.
Wait, so wouldn't the best thing to do be walk away?
Yeah, but it's gonna try and kill us. So, alright, we've seen you do this, no. Alright, let's try this again. Now, Orphan is a bastard. Like, absolutely awful. He switches between two different modes of attack. One is more dangerous than the other, and one of them can cause instant death. So if one of the first things he does is this, and you can't do anything to avoid this because it's a cutscene.
That's a dick move, man.
And he leaves us on that. So the reason I suggest it up is because if we didn't start in combat clinic, we would die instantly. Now, he's currently in consummate light mode, which means that most of his attacks are literally just claw slashes, and that's kind of it, which means we can lay a lot of damage on him. After we stagger him for the first time, that's when things are going to get really, really dangerous. So I'm going to make sure I'm properly buffed up, so I actually try and do this straight away. Because, yeah, this is going to be a problem otherwise.
Lovely.
Yeah, Orphan himself, after I've beaten him this first time, will it kind of explain what's going on.
I have to admit, this is some pretty epic freaking fight music. Just this, this like orchestra and the choir just are.
Oh yeah, as I said, this game has an amazing soundtrack. Ow.
He's just essentially bitch slapping you. That's all he's doing.
Oh yeah, but this is his easiest form of attack. Well, after I said, after I stagger him for the first time, he's then going to activate Rage Face, as in causing me to have a rage face.
Has he essentially just mated with his owl? Because that's what that fucking golden thing looks like.
Yeah, what's happened? The thing in the middle, the weird, creepy sleeping face, is actually Orphan. The shell, like the body of it, before it can be destroyed, has been created from Barthandalus and that owl, and it's used them to create itself to be born, essentially. So if it wants us to kill it, we have to kill the shell first and then kill it. Of course, right now we're kind of fighting out of necessity, because if we do eventually kill it, Cocoon's gonna go down. I should point out that he has, like, about, what, 9 million HP or something? So he has, like, the most HP of any end boss of the game, of a Final Fantasy game ever, so this is gonna be great! But we're all buffed now, so getting him staggered and doing some decent damage to start with shouldn't be too bad. It's when he changes forms that there is a chance he can just kill us instantly, which is why I equipped all those things on lightning to make sure that he can't do that. But we'll get there eventually. Alright, so I've staggered him. Unlike most enemies, he can still attack you while he's staggered. So, it's best just to keep attacking. There's no other way around it. Like, it's not like in other games where you just kind of paralyze them. I think he's kind of frozen for now because it's the first one, but later on he'll just keep going. Oh, there he goes. Yep. Again, he's in his bitch mode right now, so I'm not doing too bad. I've taken, like, well, about most of his health. I just need to do a bit of healing first. I want to try and get as much health done possible. I want to get this done in two staggers, otherwise he's gonna... Uh-oh.
Boy.
Oh, dear. Ow. Please don't let that kill me, please. Alright, I'm alive, barely. Yeah, now
heal,
he's...
Heal! Heal quickly! Heal now! Okay.
Yeah, now he has switched to Consummate Darkness, which is what that black thing is. He can inflict a bunch of status ailments on you, he can do these attacks that can kill you instantly, so I need to make sure that he doesn't do that, and I'm gonna be, like, holding my breath every time he does. So, please don't do something too extreme, because he will, and I know he will. Come on! Oh, vile exploitation, not a good one. Yeah, so he just healed himself thanks to us, that's nice.
Oh, fuck you!
Whoa. Kind of inside his face then, that was weird.
Mm-hmm. Right. It's just weird, the black cap looks like fucking Megatron.
Oh, doing it again.
Oh god.
Stop that!
The owl thing, the way he's holding that is kind of like, have you ever seen, like, game show people where they're saying, you want a new car? And the assistant's just like,
It's like, look what you can win, a sleeping Falsy. no, Progenital Wrath, not a good one.
Oh, fuck, stop it.
Fuck, he did it. That was his death, that was his instant death attack, and he fucking did it. I had 90% resistance and he still did it. Screw you. Alright, we're back. I'm gonna kill him this time. I've actually messed him up. He can't hurt me. But if he does, then we're in for a big problem. No, don't kill me. Oh.
Oh, fuck. Okay, no. Oh, God. Are we good? Are we okay? Are we fine?
Okay, Lightning, you're alive. That's fine.
Please, end him!
Alright, this should do it. No! Okay, that's fine. It's not vile exploitation that kills you, it's progenital wrath, and I keep getting those two confused and think he's gonna kill me. But to be fair, this is only the second attempt at this, so this actually hasn't gone as terribly as it usually does. I think it's just because I'm so overpowered that I was able to do that. Alright, so we survived.
Nice. Woohoo! Oh, that is creepy!
And clearly we did jack shit.
What the fuck?
I am a sword!
And so it was foretold that whoever could pull the sword from the stone would rise up!
Oh shit.
Oh, and destroy every fucking thing everywhere. Oh my god! energy beams!
Well, we don't do that. That is a good question. You are kind of like gods, so...
Exactly, that's what the thing is. Your purpose, your focus, right? Paul? Hope is out. He's out.
Oh, so is lightning.
Damn. Saz is down.
God, you're the same as the rest of them, Orphan. Fuck you. Yeah, I know we accidentally kind of let you live. That's kind of our fault. No, shit, let us know!
Oh, come on! Leave Benil alone! So what about us, bitch? Leave Benil alone, you bait, you freak!
Let her go!
We have no need of flawed the sea.
I'll do it.
Fang.
I'll destroy you.
Fang, what are you doing?
Ow.
Fang, what are you doing?
The will to guide a world unto oblivion. Can you bear the sin of our sins?
Fang.
Fang.
Don't be stupid here.
I said I'll do it.
Fang?
I'll be fine. And you can't forget our promise. We promised to save Cocoon. We promised.
I made another promise too. To protect my family.
Yeah, well, they're all dead, so...
Fang, I will kill you! Stop that!
Guys, get up and stop her.
Fang?
Sometimes. You gotta choose!
Nope!
Back off!
What are you doing? This ain't the time to be losing it, lady!
You too, huh? What do you gain from...
Sit her down!
We're in this together. This is my focus.
That's the problem with this game, like the whole thing, like you get like consumed by the idea of finishing your focus is just like so bad.
Mm-hmm.
Fang, don't know.
Fang, what are you doing? This isn't good. Oh, fuck. Now what? No! Oh, come on! Oh, no!
Is this what you meant to happen?
You got tricked, Fang. I'm sorry.
Wait, what the hell? They all became Seath!
Yep.
What the fuck?
That's such a kick in the teeth.
What?
Yeah, basically Fang was like, no, I can finally complete the focus, I can do it. And then she kind of went, No, whoops.
Guess I deserve it. After what I did.
Yes, you do.
What the fucking hell? I'm confused here. What? So.
For choosing salvation.
Yes, she basically became consumed by the idea of completing her focus. So Orphan gave her the power, like, now I'll back you all off and I'll destroy Orphan myself, and then in doing so, Seath. So yeah. Orphan's a dick. Fang needs to think more before she does things.
Okay, so okay, oh wait, what the fuck? Her brand, what's happening? Her brand's active again! What the hell?
Yes, Orphan basically said, yeah, if you want to become Ragnarok, you do bad things.
Okay. Okay, I thought that the Ragnarok was this, like, giant fucking monster. That's not that bad.
I say, she's not doing a very good job, is she?
Oh, that's creepy.
Oh, she's broken off from shell. Oh, there's the gate.
Oh, we're all fucked now.
So here's just a reflection on, here's everything you did. And you failed. Well,
this is such bullshit, man.
Here's the time I looked sexy in front of some army guys.
I remember this. You guys remember this? We were there.
Oh.
I like that.
Good times. I remember that. That was great.
Like, I remember that. That felt good. Here, let me do it again. Ah! It was very therapeutic for me. Drive us.
We just had things worth fighting for.
Wait, was this all another fucking Lassie trick?
Oh. Fang, you didn't do it. How many times must you? Yeah, because she was the one who scarred Cocoon in the past, and she's failed again. I feel really sorry for Fang, because she only tries to do her best to try and stop being a Lassie, and she can't do it. Oh dear.
Oh man. I've read too many fanfiction to know what's gonna happen now. Don't tell me Vanille's gonna do something here.
Dang.
What do you want?
He just told you, to be fair, but ow.
So they attack, then they heal. They attack, then they heal.
Yeah, it's torture trying to get her to submit. It sucks. Vanille,
what are you doing? Vanille.
Your awakening demands an offering of pain.
Vanille, run.
No! I swore I wouldn't run away anymore!
Not the time to be doing that, sweetheart! Without even trying.
Hey!
What the fuck?
Hang on, who saved us? Hey!
But he was. What?
You've got to be.
What? What?
Yeah, who'd be dumb enough to swallow that clock?
Sure. We've all had better weeks.
Fuck, I'll say.
But you can't be.
But
could be more Falsey smoke and mirrors.
Another illusion. Okay. Yeah, the false the false here officially dicks.
Second time now, isn't it?
Yeah, they kind of tricked you, didn't they, Fang?
Wait, did the Falsi trick them, or did we trick them? I don't understand.
Yeah, Orphan made it seem as though they'd all been turned into Seath. They hadn't been.
Somewhere cold and
it was to try and make Fang submit to hatred and everything like that and become Ragnarok, and it partially worked. And they kind of got, like, glimpsed away, like, out of the pitch after they became Seath because it was an illusion. So, no, they're fine.
I don't smile. I don't laugh.
I do, just rarely.
Very rarely. I don't. And my hand will be covering my face.
The chocobo's alive! Yeah!
Bloop! Back in the apron. You were there too, Fang. Same side. All of us. Together to the end. I love how this, like, thing's just letting them have their moment. Just... Yeah, just talk. I'll be here whenever you decide to pay attention.
I'd say, to be fair, they did just, like, kind of set it on fire.
This is true.
Yeah, that was, it was the time you made Vanille cry.
Aww.
Yeah, these two are great.
He's her mommy!
We have a new family now. We stick together. You hear me?
Hypocrite!
Yes, I promise.
Now fix it!
We promised, didn't we?
Head tilt.
You'll pay for that, bitch!
Yeah, well, to be fair, you let Fang destroy your shield, so it's your fault now. Now, it isn't explicitly stated in the dialogue.
Wait, whoa.
Yeah.
What?
The symbol of the focus we all faced.
Huh?
The mark of the fate we all shared. Proof of the promise.
I mean, Hope will say something in a minute that'll kind of explain what's going to happen next. Alright, so well, the shell's been destroyed at least.
Heroes never die. Come on.
No matter how incompetent they are.
Go on, Huff, explain it.
If we have the power to destroy Cocoon, then we have the power to save it.
What?
Yeah, from that, what they're basically saying, throughout the entire game, they've been fighting against the Falsi. They've been trying to say the Falsi can't rule over us anymore, so we're gonna do it. We're gonna set the people free from the Falsi. They know that if they destroy Orphan, Cocoon will fall, but they realize that if we have the power to destroy it, then we can also use our power to save the world. You know, because they're people. They have the unlimited power that they have as human beings, not as Lassi, which is why the Falsi want them. So they're basically resolving, we're going to set humans free from Falsi rule, and we're going to save the planet. And they can do it. I believe in you guys.
Oh god, what is that noise?
Well, it's about time the true Orphan showed up.
That's creepy.
Hello.
Golden Armor Digivolve!
Except you're, like, even smaller than before, so it's not really a good one. Hey, dude.
Well, there were a couple of Digivolutions where they got smaller than they were in their, like, mega forms.
I'm just gonna say Lightning Speech here is amazing, so I just wanna pay attention to this, because it's really good.
Oh, God. You don't believe in anything.
You gave up on life before you were even born. Sat poisoning Cocoon from the inside, waiting for someone to come and destroy you. Sure. You think the end of the world is salvation. All you care about is death's release. So take it, and leave the rest of us alone. We don't think like that. When we think there's no hope left, we keep looking until we find some. Maybe Cocoon is past saving, but it's our home, and we'll protect it or die trying. We live to make the impossible possible. That is our focus.
All right. Let's do this. Right, yeah, Orphan. The only way you can damage him is if you stagger him, and that basically means going all out and attacking him. He also sets a doom counter on, so if we don't do it in time, we die.
Yay! Oh, what kind of bullshit claim is that?
Oh, he slowed me down. Lovely. Another thing he can do, as I've said before, he can attack you while he's staggered. So I can juggle him in the air when he's staggered, I can do a bunch of stuff to him, but he can still attack me back. So this is very much how quickly can you do things kind of a battle. Oh god. He has wicked weaves!
But it's like, oh my god, we're going cartoony! We're stretching! We're tiny! We're toony! They're all a little loony! I miss Tiny Toons.
I don't think I have a sort of necrosis. Oh shit, he's frozen Fang completely.
Oh fuck!
Fix it! Fix it! Well done, Hook.
Fix it! No!
Uh-oh.
Oh my god, we've got Millennium Puzzle here!
Ow! Ah, wasn't too bad. Alright, I've staggered him, and now he's become an angel, for those reasons.
Smacky, 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 smashy, smashy!
We can do it! I don't want Fang to go down. She's too much of a good damage dealer. I need her to stay alive.
You must live.
Well, he's almost up to full stagger, so I'll just... I guess I'll just wreck him.
Just wreck his shit, man. Just do it.
Go on, Fang. Do your stupidly high damage because you are you.
Even though that stupidly high damage was not enough to bust through a barrier.
Yeah, I have to say, you became a monster and you failed it then.
So now show us your true form!
Oh shit, I just did full number damage. That was awesome.
Alright. When the hell did that thing get hands?
Rebirth. Oh, you're a clock again. Oh, he's buffed himself. Screw you, man.
What the shit? Oh my god, he healed?
Okay, well, you know what, dude? You know what? I think two staggers is all I'm gonna need. I'm just gonna let Hulk buff me a little bit. Yeah, one more should do it.
Oh god, wicked weave! Oh god!
Wow!
Woohoo! Bitch, that's my move!
She just comes in out of nowhere and stamps him.
No, they just like lightning goes in for the killing blow and all of a sudden a giant boot comes out of nowhere and smashes him.
What the?
Oh, bitch!
Did I steal your moment of glory?
Sorry, dear, but that's my move. I will not have this thing using it.
Oh, she'll probably mistake it for another angel. It is all like gold and shiny.
Oh, yeah. Like, what? No halos? Cheeky!
Right, stagger him, let's do lightning super move, and yeah. I've got about half my time left for the doom counter, so I should be okay. Come on, he's almost down, yeah!
Die! Die, die, die!
Wah! Ow! Wow, I did terrible. How are you supposed to do it any faster than that? That's dumb. Yeah, I got another expansion if I want to do the post-game. Doesn't matter. Orphan is going nuclear!
We have now entered Dragon Ball Z territory, man.
Orphan isn't stupid. Everyone else should leave.
We're here to stop it. We've come to save Cocoon, right? Right. But he wants to die. You killed him. How do you stop this now?
You're about to say it goes, alright, we've got the power to save Cocoon now. How the fuck are we gonna do that?
Mm-hmm.
Which leads to this.
Leads to what the flying fuck?
Come on. The suspense is killing me. Come on, just go back to normal. Okay.
Oh my god, it's the cradle of creation.
Yeah, that's Etra's gate, the thing that the Falsi wanted to open to bring the Maker back. There's the sun shutting down, there's everything else shutting down.
We're all gonna die! We're all gonna die! Oh god!
We didn't do so well.
We done fucked up, guys! Game's over, man! Game's over!
Oh no, we're turning to crystal!
This is such bullshit!
I mean, we technically completed the focus, so... Wait!
Fang! Vanille! No! No, 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 no! No! Oh, come on, that's bullshit! That is some bullshit shit right here!
Vanille? Wishes can come true.
What?
But not if you just wait for miracles. Ready.
I'm confused. What the fuck are you doing?
Miracles are things we make for ourselves. Here and now.
What? What?
Look, it's the vision from the beginning of the game. Oh, Cocoon's falling. Right, so they've become Ragnarok, basically. But remember, they say if they have the power to destroy Cocoon, they can also save it. So what they've done here is they've basically chosen, we're going to become Ragnarok and get its power, but we're going to use it to save Cocoon. By
okay.
Doing this.
How the fuck does... What? Iblis has been born!
I hope not. You're not slowing it down, guys.
Guys, this is... No. Shadow did a better job.
Oh, my.
Oh. Abba Genko! Shit, it's not doing anything. Oh, what the hell?
You've almost done it, guys.
Okay, so instead of floating, it's now a giant thing. Ah, it's creepy! We're lava babies.
Did they do it? Oh, they get shut. You might recognize that from the logo of the game.
Mm-hmm.
It's Cocoon. Saved.
Damn.
And the rest of us, not so much.
Damn. Now we're all a rock garden. So does anybody know any good songs that we can start humming in our head for the next few billion years?
Oh, lightning.
We're all naked.
Sarah was too.
Hmm.
Wake up.
Huh? Oh, yay, vocals. Pretty sounds. Oh, wait, what? They got all their clothes back. That's not what happened before. What?
They did.
Yeah, but where are they?
They gave us a new one. That's one gift I'll forgive them for not rapping.
Wow, Saz.
Yeah.
This is as much as we can do. The rest is up to you.
Does this mean we completed our focus?
Cocoon's seen better days, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was about to say, you did a number on that.
Whatever you want to believe. It really is a miracle.
Hey, look!
It's
Oh my god!
Yeah, the rules don't apply anymore because the Falci aren't around, so...
We're gone!
You know,
yay!
Anyone who was in Crystal or had a focus has been set free.
Okay, but what happened to Dodge? What about Sarah? What? Hello? Oh, there they are. Okay.
Look.
Saz, go run up and scoop your child.
Dodge! Aww.
Yay! I love this music.
It's a very, it's a nice ending song.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Hope, they're not here.
They're gone, aren't they?
Hey. I guess they meant for this to be goodbye. And again, we've changed our fates before.
Hmm. Maybe they're just another rock garden somewhere. Who knows?
I missed you. Sarah, I'm sorry. It's okay.
Hey, come on, the apologies can wait. What's your plan? You aren't gonna allow it.
Wow. Don't push your luck.
Don't waste any time, do you?
No, I don't.
Right, just charge in, guns blazing.
Well, we don't know what else is going to come out of the horizon. Something might try to eat us.
I swear to you, I will make her happy.
I believe you.
Besides, you break her heart, I break your neck.
Well, that's the end of Cocoon, but they've found a new life on Grand Pulse, and somewhere in amidst all of this...
When prayers turn to promises, not even fate can stand in their way.
Ha! Told you, they're just a rock garden somewhere.
And achieve the impossible. Now we live on. To greet a new dawn.
And that's it! That's Final Fantasy XIII, everyone! It was a long journey, involving cheating, and grinding, and a bunch of other stuff. But yeah. I think this game is really wonderful. I love its story, I love its battle system and everything, and I'm glad that we were able to do this thanks to the PC version. I suppose the biggest question of the day is Dragon Scale, considering this is the first full Final Fantasy thing you've seen through to fruition. Your thoughts?
Well, I have to admit, in the beginning I was very confused. I'm a little confused now, but they explained it very well, so I'm kind of understanding what's going on, if not a bit of minor details that I may bug the hell out of you about later.
Music.
I love the visuals.
Sorry. Masashi Hamazu needs to give a shout out to you for being amazing.
Yes, bow to your amazingness. Yeah. And all of the people who did the singing for the choir, all of you wonderful lovelies.
Yeah.
Because that is not easy.
Do carry on.
But the visuals were amazing. The character designs were awesome. I love the character arc for Lightning. When she starts out as like this awful, just complete cold-hearted bitch. And you actually see her change throughout the story with reasoning behind it, which is really nice. I can't say the same for Snow, really. I don't feel very connected to him at all, if for nothing else, more than just, hey, comic relief, look at me.
He's a bit of a bitch, but he kind of understands, yeah, okay, maybe I'm not as much of a hero as I thought, so.
He's like, yeah, I'm not that cool. You know, you got, Hope went through a great character arc when it was just like, oh, simple revenge, then what the fuck am I gonna be doing? You know, teach me to fight, and now I'm just like, I can stand on my own 2 feet and be like, fuck your face. But, you know, the characters themselves are just, I like them. The designs, I'm gonna keep killing myself for.
QR codes, but it'll give you a challenge.
Oh yeah, well I've got almost everybody with the exception of Fang, Saz, and I think that's the entire group. I've got everybody else.
And look, voice actors: Ali Hillis, you're amazing. Troy Baker, we all know who you are. Vincent Martella, your greatest hope. Fang,
Laura
Sarah.
Bailey.
Yep, Laura Bailey's in there. Some of the Cocoon inhabitants you might notice. James Arnold Taylor's in that list.
Oh yes, Kalina Shemesi. Genius!
Yep,
Kirk.
Yep, they're all Yuri Wenthal, there he is.
Oh my god!
Yeah, they're in there somewhere.
Tales of Symphonia, my sage siblings!
Yeah, they're in there. There's a lot of voices. But yeah, I think this game gets a really, like, unjust rap. I think that people are way too harsh on it for what it is. I think the story it tells is really good. Like, just the whole idea of, like, trying to conquer fate and, you know, the whole aspect of if you've got the right spirit and the determination, you can do it. I think, like, the whole design of everything is really well thought out. There's a lot of stuff. Yeah, maybe they should have explained more of it in-game than in all the data logs and stuff, but I still think it's a lovely thing to behold. And the best thing is that that's not the end of the story. There is still Final Fantasy XIII 2, which continues on 3 years after the events of this game. There's also Lightning Returns, which carries on, well, 500 years after that, which you'll see the reasons for as we go on. So yeah, we're not done with the 13 universe yet. We'll be able to go back and we'll see all these characters again. And they also have PC versions that are fully working and I'll be able to record them fine. And it's going to be great. And I hope you'll join us for those ones too. So yeah.
Yay, music. Nice.
Yeah, even just the ending credits music is a lovely thing. If you really want some really good game soundtracks, I would heartily recommend getting the soundtrack for this. It's like four discs of really nice orchestral stuff.
Look at the fairies! We all are flat! Yeah.
I also need to give props to almost every single artist and animation person here, because with the CGI cutscenes alone, you all these guys are amazing. All the comms, it's the editors, the engineers for all of it. You're all great people. Visual works, you're awesome. Keep going. Hey, Dodge, remember when you turned to a crystal and I thought you died? Wasn't that great?
Here's my question. He looked like he was just inside of a crystal. He wasn't actually crystallized.
Yeah, I think it's just probably just different designs. Maybe it works differently for kids. I don't know.
I was about to say, I was looking at that because, like, everybody else, their bodies are crystal. But this kid looks like he was just frozen in a block of ice.
Oh, look at all the music people. Oh, you're
Yay.
Amazing. Conductor. Yay. Oh, the Warsaw Philharmonic Orchestra. You're all great. Choir recordings and everything.
Yes. All of you choir people, excellent. Your harmonies were amazing. Props to you all.
Oh, and there's the ending song, the My Hands thing from Leona Lewis, which the Japanese version doesn't have, actually.
Put different music into the different ports. Zestiria does that actually with the opening song, White Light.
Yeah.
The Japanese version has the lyrics. English does not.
How odd. I wonder why.
I don't know. All I know is they took the lyrics out and replaced it with an electric guitar.
Huh.
How Which strange. Was very odd.
Hey, remember all that time when Snow gave away the fact that we were a sea?
Oh yeah, I was like, yeah! Oh my god, he's a monster! Shit.
Yeah.
God damn it, Snow!
Snow!
So Snowku!
Snow, you damu!
Snow, you bucket the rat!
Oh, look, and this is the bit where Vanille was useless at combat.
Oh, he didn't touch me. Okay.
Oh, and it was also the bit where Lightning was a BAMF. Look at this.
Woo-hoo. Even more BAMF? Oh, man. Oh, and when Vanille landed on her ass?
Please show that.
please show Vinny landing on her ass.
Do it. No, okay. Never mind.
Oh. What the action?
A lot of people worked on this game. For all different languages and all.
What?
War.
Oh god. Dear. What are you putting on my Netflix, babe? Jeez!
Yeah, you won't hear this either. They're having an argument about Netflix like modern couples do.
Okay, first and foremost, why do you assume everything's an argument? I'm just talking.
It's to get that exact reaction. As I said, they don't know what you're saying, so I'm just building up a great image in their heads.
Oh, you bastard.
Oh, I get it. You're just fucking with me. Okay.
You are a bastard. Snow, watch the road! Or the sky, or whatever. Stop looking at your baby!
No, you instead kissed the girl.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la, my oh my!
It's a firework in my eye. Go on, kiss the girl.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la, ain't that sad? I'll never see out of my eye again.
I should be driving, but I'm not.
And that pretty much wraps up the game. So, with a parting, I guess, from me, this has been The Grudge 154. That on the other side of the Atlantic has been...
Dragon Scale 8374.
And we actually got the numbers right. I remembered to include them this time. That, everyone, was Final Fantasy XIII. So please join us for our next game, whatever that may be.